Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gary GZ Duels, and back by popular demand, here it is, the deck profile for the Stardust Assault Mode, Heretic Stardust Assault Mode deck. It's pretty good. I'm playing with it. It's pretty fun. I just woke up one day. Somebody messaged me about Stardust Assault Mode. Shout outs to you. You know who you are. And I just got to thinking, why not just revive this deck? And Heretic seemed like the perfect engine to do it. So without further ado, let me go into the deck profile for the vanilla monsters. We have this Labradorite Dragon, this level 6 Dragon Tuner Dark, as well as Galaxy Serpent, level 2 Dragon Tuner, and as well as the Flamveil Guard, level 1 Dragon Tuner. We have to run the two mandatory Stardust Assault Modes. One Red MD, because it helps with the Heretic combo. You need the Dragon Rulers. I run three only. I run the Blaster because it has really good attack. It has a good effect in the hand. Plus, it searches for the Flamveil Guard, a level 1 tuner. So sometimes you can make a level 8 synchro happen when you really don't have that much resources. I also go with one Tempest. Tempest allows you to search for the Debris Dragon. It's not bad. Plus, you know, it's just another Dragon Ruler. Having three Dragon Rulers gives you the better ability to go into rank 7 XYZ. I don't run Tidal because it really has no synergy with the deck other than like really high attack, as well as Redox. Redox is really good because you run the Earth Monster that is Assault Beast. You discard into the graveyard, and then you can just banish Assault Beasts in order to summon out the Redox. Is really versatile in this deck. Plus, if you have a Earth Monster in your hand, you know, Assault Beast, you can also use it as a Monster Reborn. One more thing about Tempest is that if you happen to draw into an unfortunately a Stardust Assault Mode, it's a Wind Dragon type monster, so you can discard the Stardust Assault Mode plus your Tempest in order to search for whatever dragon monster you need, like, you know, Heretic Dragon of Su, Tefnuit, as well as Essence. So it really runs the deck that much better. For the Heretic engine part, we have 3 Su, 3 Tefnuit, and 3 Essit. Nothing really needs to be said about them. They're really good. If you go first, you want to have Essit plus Su. If you go second, it's very good if you have Tefnuit plus Su, or, you know, just Tefnuit plus whichever. That's usually how it goes. And then for the other monsters, we have 3 Assault Beasts because you need this to search for someone to activate, and you have 1 Debris Dragon because it's a really good dragon tuner. One thing to note though, Labradorite Dragon has 0 attack, so it can make for some really scary plays. If you special summon out like Tefnuit, and then you Debris Dragon, and then you can pull back a Labradorite Dragon, and if you have like Dragon Ruler, you can go for some really high level XYZs over here. It's pretty versatile. For the spells, you have 3 Heretic Seal of Convocation. This is what makes the deck really good, because you can search for the relevant pieces needed to go into your Stardust Dragon. You also play it this way because you can. You also play Heretics because you can play the Wingbeat of a Giant Dragon. It's a pretty overpowered card. It's like a Heavy Storm in a format where there's no Heavy Storm, so people tend to set everything. But on Death Pro, you need to be careful when you use this, because if your opponent goes first and then he all of a sudden sets 5, don't just go Wingbeat, because sometimes they play the new deck called Artifacts and then you just lose. So make sure you know what your opponent's playing before you go Wingbeat. It's really good because you can special summon a Dragon Ruler, bounce it back, destroy all the backfield. Special summon out Tefnuit, bounce it back, destroy all the backfield. It's very, very good. I run cards of consonants because you do sometimes draw into these normal tuners, or maybe you draw into a Debris Dragon and you really don't want them, and it's plus it's a extra draw power because if you happen to draw into your Labradorite Dragon, there's not much you can do with it except for tribute summoning it, which is pretty bad. But other than that, you know, you can just discard it because it has 0 attack. It's a dragon tuner. You can draw 2 cards out of it, so it's pretty good. I only run 1 because there's not too many targets. There's a fair amount. Plus, I played the Gold Sark, so you're able to search for a dragon tuner. But, you know, 1 is good. I've tried it at 2. It's kind of cloggy. Tried it at 1. You kind of see it sometimes when you need it. Plus 2 Dragon Shrine. Dragon Shrine at 2 is the perfect number. You run 3, you can't use more than once per turn. It's very versatile because you can send one of your Laboratory Dragons into the grave, as well as a Dragon Ruler. So you shrink the deck by 2, plus you get into some valuable resources. It's pretty awesome. 3 Upstart Goblins to help with the consistency. You don't care about giving your opponent life points as long as you can lock them down with Stardust Assault Mode. 1 Gold Sark because you want to search for a Dragon Ruler monster. It really helps you with like backup plans, going to Draco Sack, going to other Synchro monsters. Plus, it allows you to search for tuners like Debris Dragon as well as Flamevel Guard if you happen to go for Blaster or Tempest. 3 Tanky because you want to search for the Assault Beast, and then you can go into, of course, the 3 Assault Mode Activates so that you have basically 9 targets for getting into Assault Mode Activate. Yeah, that's the main deck. In the extra deck, you run 1 Star Eater, 1 Trident Dragon, 1 Crimson Blader, 1 Scrap Dragon. I really don't think I need to explain these guys. These guys are really good by themselves. 2 Stardust Dragon because you have the capability to go into both Stardust Assault Modes, as well as 1 Stardust Spark Dragon, and 1 Black Rose Dragon. Rank 7 XYZ, we have Draco Sack, Gaia Charger, Gaia Dragon Thunder Charger, as well as the Big Eye. For the rank 6 XYZ, Ptolemy's M7, Photon Strike Bouncer, Gauntlet Launcher, and Heretic Dragon King Atum. You really don't need 2 because you're not focused on getting this out. If you do get it out, it's probably early game, so you don't have to worry about, you know, needing it late game anyway. So yeah, this is the extra deck. For the side deck, the deck runs into a lot of problems. I will post a video tomorrow about the weaknesses of the deck. So in order to deal with the weaknesses, I have the full extra deck set up. It sometimes hinders your consistency, but other times it really helps you deal with like problem matchups. So some of the weaknesses you will see in the next video. So I'm just gonna give you the side deck right here: 2 Maxi against the decks that try to outpace you, 3 Mystical Space Typhoon, and 2 Twister against decks that try to lock you down with continuous spell and traps. Example would be Vanity's Emptiness, Kaiser Coliseum, some sort of spell field card like Necro Valley, stuff like that. Yeah, so you need these 3 guys and these 2 guys. Also, if your opponent's trying to play the back row game, putting down a lot of spell traps for you to push through, that sometimes can hurt. 3 XYZ Encore because you don't want to get controlled by a XYZ monster such as Ophion or Pleiades. Those guys can really hurt you. 3 Imperial Iron Wall because you're afraid that your Stardust will get banished in the graveyard. But then, you know, if you want to side these in, you probably would take your Dragon Rulers out, or maybe not, because Dragon Rulers do add to the consistency of the deck, as well as 2 Skill Drain. Skill Drain really works very well in this deck because when you negate the effect of something with Stardust Assault Mode, the effect resolves into the grave. So Skill Drain only negates effects that occur on the field, while it locks down most of your opponent's monsters. You know, if your opponent's playing things that are like effect heavy on the field, you will be able to lock them down further. So if you have any questions about the deck, please feel free to drop in the comments. I will answer them. If you have any suggestions for the deck or how you want to play it, please drop it in the comment section down below too. We're all learning right here. I hope you enjoyed the video. This is Gary GZ Duels signing out.